Hi everyone, my name's Harrison. I'm one of the senior support agents here at Nexudus. Today, we'll be taking a look at customisable home dashboards. This webinar will last around 15 to 20 minutes and we will be taking questions throughout. If you do have any queries, please post them in the QA section on Zoom and one of the team will be on hand to answer. You'll be able to find the recording of this webinar, as well as all of our other webinars, via our knowledge base at help.nexudus.com. They will also be posted to our YouTube channel, that's youtube.com/@Nexudus. Today, we'll be exploring the advantages of using customizable home dashboards. We'll be learning how to create and configure our own dashboard. We can take a look at the dashboard functions and how we can customize these to cater to your team's needs. And we'll also be discovering how to best pinpoint areas of focus for your space, tailored to your business goals and keeping your team in the loop, all from one centralized hub. Moving on to the dashboard itself, it is the first thing that you see when you log into the admin panel. The dashboard does house quite a lot of data with some helpful graphs and charts, so you can see exactly what's happening within your space. Some of the tiles under each dashboard are clickable. So for example, if we head over to the admin panel and go into the checked in customers tile here, we can click this and be redirected to exactly who's checked into the space that day. The dashboard does have six presets for every admin. So this is the Now dashboard, which gives you an overview of what's happening in your space that day. The Memberships dashboard tracks your active memberships over a month and allows you to get an overview of how many contracts you can expect to start and end this month. The Finance dashboard, it's a great tool to get an overview of payments you've already collected this month against the revenue that you're waiting to receive. The Occupancy dashboard tracks floor plan occupancy in your space and lets you check your space's occupancy progression. The Booking dashboard tracks the total booking time in your space over the last month, along with the total revenue generated by those bookings. The CRM dashboard tracks how many opportunities you've won and lost over the last month, as well as get an overview of opportunities moving within your space's CRM boards. So before we go ahead and look at adding those dashboards, we should take a look at what cards we can add. There are over 50 cards that can be added to each new dashboard, and a full list can be found on our knowledge base, and the knowledge base article is Dashboard Cards List. Here we can see each card and a description of what data it would display. So initially we have the sensors cards. These provide information on integrated sensors or your own sensors. We do have a separate webinar on sensors, and I really would recommend you check that out if you need more information on that side of things. We have the operations cards. These cards provide information on various aspects, including booking statistics, deliveries, help desk requests, all of this with historical data over the last 7 days. The billing cards provide information to help monitor active contracts, cancellations, invoices, payment statuses within your location. It helps provide an overall insight into the financial aspects. The CRM cards offer a comprehensive view of customer relation management in general, so including document statuses, opportunity tracking, proposal management, task monitoring, facilitating efficient customer engagement and your task management within your location. And finally there, the community cards allow you to track the number of new event attendees, form responses and newsletter subscribers on a daily basis and over the last 7 days. Once we've created a dashboard and added the cards, we can then edit the card's position, size and name. We can do this by simply dragging and dropping each card, or we can use the arrow in the bottom right to resize the cards. With cards that have the historical data, making the card larger will then display a graph of the data for that historical period. Also on each card are the three dots in the top right. This is like the More Action section. These options can rename the card, remove the card, or on some cards you're able to click on Show Records. This will do similar how it did to the checked in customers, redirect you so you can see that data in full. After the cards have been set up, we're then able to share the dashboard to all admins of the space. You can do this via the edit section of the dashboard itself, and this way we can create a dashboard and then share these with the rest of the team so they can all easily see the same information. Something to note that if the dashboard isn't shared, it would only appear for the user that created it. We are able to hide and reorder dashboards in general, and this is included newly created and the preset dashboards. To do this, When looking at any dashboard, we can click on the cog in the top right. We can use the lines and to the left of each dashboard to reorder the cards, and we can also use the eye icons to hide or to reveal those dashboards. Something else to note here, this is also per user. So if you were to share a dashboard with your team and a specific user doesn't need to see that dashboard, they're able to then go in them and hide that dashboard for themselves. Now that we've taken a look into custom dashboards, we can head into the admin panel and add a new dashboard and share this across all users of the space. So in the dashboard, we'd click the plus add button here next to all the dashboards. This gives us a pop-up to name the card of this new dashboard. Just in this case, we'll be adding a dashboard for a receptionist to look at, for example. The name here isn't final and can be changed at a later date. However, what we do now is either add card here or in the bottom left, and this would give us all of the types that we saw previously. So for the receptionist, they want to look at bookings, check-ins and visitors. So we can add these cards accordingly. So we can go for booked hours, bookings today with a 7-day history, check-ins today with a 7-day history, as well as some visitor information. So visitors expected today, visitors expected in general, and then visitors that are actually on site. Once we've selected the ones that we want and hit add cards, here we can then drag and move these. So if we put all the visitors section on the right, for example, and we can also resize these cards to show some historical data. So we can see the bookings over the past few days, for example. If a card has been added on accident, we can click the three dots in the top right and remove this card. And similarly, if we wanted to rename a card, we can click the three dots and click rename. So if we'd call this future visitors, just as an example, this card would then be renamed like so. As mentioned, we can also show the records of these visitors. So if we go view records, we can then see what visitors are expected to show today. The last thing here would be sharing that dashboard. So we can click onto the edit tab, and here we can select make this dashboard available to all users. This would then share the dashboard with everyone in the space, and we can also allow all those users to edit the card as well. And finally there, we can also rename this dashboard as well. The last thing to mention here would be that the dashboard can be moved around or hidden. So if we only really wanted the now tab and the receptionist tab, then we can go ahead and hide the rest. And as you can see at the top there, just those two tabs now appear. So that does bring us to the end of the webinar. Thank you so much for joining. I hope you've helped kind of more understand the dashboard section. We will leave the webinar open for another 5 to 10 minutes for any questions that you may still have. Thank you much again for joining. Have a great day.